Hello friends, welcome to video lecture series on basic electronics. I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda and today we will discuss the importance of semiconductor in electronics. Since previous lecture we saw that semiconductor materials are unique materials as compared to the conductors and insulators. Today let us see how they are very important in electronics and communication engineering. So this will be the contents of our class. We will justify that semiconductors are the backbone of electronics. We will see different semiconductor materials. We will see the properties of semiconductors and we will see applications of semiconductors. So starting with the semiconductors. Semiconductors are the materials for which electrical conductivity falls intermediate between that of conductors and insulators. The conductivity of semiconductor is higher as compared to insulators and lower as compared to conductors, and therefore they come in between, right? Semiconductors conduct electricity better than the insulators but not as good as the conductors, hence they are called semi or half conductors, right? Semiconductor materials are responsible for the development of field of electronics and communication engineering. See, they have unique properties compared to conductors and have a unique way of supporting the flow of electric current. How? See, unlike conductors where the charge carriers are only electrons, here there are two types of carriers, electrons and holes. There are two types of semiconductors, p-type semiconductor and n-type semiconductor. See, when these two are joined, they form a basic p-n junction diode which is used for rectification, that is converting AC into DC, and today majority of our electronic devices are working on DC, right? A PNP material or NPN materials joined together are used as transistors, the devices which are used for amplifying weak electric signal, a very important application of semiconductors to amplify weak signals. Number of transistors fabricated on a silicon wafer forms an integrated circuit chip or IC chip or microprocessor chip used in different electronic devices, smartphones, computers, etc. Hence, semiconductor can be called the backbone of electronics, right? Because electronics and communication field has developed because of the development of the field of semiconductors. Let's go ahead. Let us see different semiconductor materials. So, the most widely used semiconductor materials are silicon and germanium. The other semiconductor materials which are used are selenium, gratine, tellurium, etc. Also, some compounds also act as semiconductors such as gallium arsenide, gallium phosphide, gallium arsenide phosphide, zinc antimonode, indium antimonode, etc. Let us see the properties of semiconductors. The temperature coefficient of resistance for semiconductors is negative. That is, as the temperature increases, the resistivity decreases. This is a very important property of semiconductor. Okay, the temperature coefficient of resistance is negative. Okay, suppose this is temperature T and this is resistance R. So for semiconductor, the graph is like this. Okay, with the increase in temperature, the resistance get decreased. So slope of this graph will come out to be negative. Therefore, we say that the temperature coefficient of resistance for semiconductors is negative. Here the current increases rapidly than voltage. That is, Ohm's law is not observed in the semiconductors and therefore they are non-linear resistors. So according to Ohm's law, V is equal to I into R. V is equal to IR. So for conductors, the graph will be like this. But with the increase in voltage, okay, the current will increase. So this is called Ohm's law. But for semiconductor, the current increases rapidly than voltage, and Ohm's law is not observed. Okay, the graph is something like this for semiconductors, like this. So here you can see that the current I is increasing rapidly as compared to the voltage V, right? So therefore they are called non-linear resistors, right? The resistivity of semiconductor decreases under the effect of illumination, meaning is to say that when light falls on semiconductor materials, its resistivity decreases and conductivity increases. This is also a very important property which is used in applications like light dependent resistor, etc. The resistivity of a semiconductor is changed considerably by even a very small amount of external impurities, 1 part in 10 raised to 6. So in 10 raised to 6 atoms, if you add 1 atom of impurity, then the resistivity of semiconductor is changed considerably. The resistivity decreases and the conductivity increases by a very small amount of external impurities, right? So this is also a very important property of semiconductor. Let us see the applications of semiconductors. They are used in rectifiers to convert AC into DC. Very important property, because major of our electronic devices, televisions, computers, laptops, music systems, all are working on DC and not AC, and what we are getting from the mains line is AC, right? They are used in transistors to amplify weak signals, convert low amplitude signal to high amplitude signal, a very, very important application of a semiconductor material, because due to amplification only, we are getting the signal many, many times larger as compared to the input signal that we have given. They are used in thermistors, that is thermally sensitive resistor, a resistor which is sensitive to temperature or heat. So when the heat is applied, okay, the resistivity decreases and conductivity increases. They are used in varistors or voltage variable resistors, resistors which are varied by voltage. So if you apply voltage, what will happen? Resistivity will decrease, right? They are used in light sensitive photoelectric devices, namely photoemissive cells, photoconductive cells and photovoltaic cells. So in all these photoelectric devices, whenever light falls on it, the conductivity increases. They are used in refrigerators. Automatic refrigerator, it will turn on and off automatically as per the temperature. They are used in televisions, radios, audio systems, computers, etc. They are used in heating appliances. They are used in instrument displays, digital watches, calculators, multimeters, etc. They are used in automatic and remote control cars. Many, many applications of semiconductors. They are used everywhere where the term automatic comes. So that's all for this video lecture. I hope you would have gained a good knowledge from this video lecture. Thank you very much.